Hello everyone. In this episode I will look into a simple but very useful module for the modular case, the sample and hold module. A sample and hold is a quite common circuit that has a lot of use in test and measurement equipment and of course in analog synthesizers. There are basically two ways of building one, using a dedicated integrated circuit, for example the LF398, or building one with discrete components. The latter method is often used in DIY synthesizers, since the sample and hold ICs are quite expensive. The Prophet 5, for example, uses 38 sample and hold circuits to demultiplex the output from the 14-bit digital to analog converter and route that to the various control voltages in the analog part of the synthesizer. The design is based on a CMOS switch, a film capacitor, and an op-amp. I will use a JFET instead of a CMOS switch, but it's basically the same circuit, since sampling noise to get a random control voltage is one of the most common uses of the sample and hold. I will also add a white noise source. But let's jump into the schematic diagram and take a look at the design. So, here in the center we have the sample and hold circuit with the input buffer and the switch and the hold capacitor and finally the output buffer. We have the trigger input that controls the gate of the FET, and we also have a trigger indication circuit here with a red LED. Finally, we have the noise circuit, and as you can see, the noise output is normaled to the signal input. And yeah, that's basically it. Alright, I decided to make a module with 4 HP width. And when I studied the datasheet of the LF398, I found an interesting note about PCB layout recommendations to reduce leak currents in the circuit around the hold capacitor. By placing a guard ring around the high impedance net of the hold capacitor and connect it to the buffered output, the leakage is reduced. Selecting the right type of capacitor is also very important. Polypropylene or polystyrene capacitors are recommended. I used two separate TL072s instead of one TL074. The idea behind that is to separate the sensitive hold circuit from the white noise generator and the trigger input. They are also located away from each other on the PCB. The final step is to complete the front panel, produce the BOM and Gerber files, and sign it off for PCB manufacturing. And while the PCBs were manufactured and shipped back to me, I started to investigate which type of capacitor I should use for this design. The polypropylene capacitors are quite expensive and a bit difficult to source, so I gravitated towards the polystyrene or PET caps from Vima in the MKS2 series. They have a 5mm footprint, but I also decided to add 10mm footprints for the polypropylene caps too, just in case someone wants to use that. After the PCBs arrived, I started to assemble the PCBs. The design have a low part count, so it didn't take much time to complete the first one. And after the SMT parts were soldered to the board, I cleaned it thoroughly with IPA, or rubbing alcohol, especially around the area where the hold capacitor and the noise transistor were located. Next step was to mount the through-hole components, and I started by soldering the hole capacitor and cleaning the solder joints with IPA again. After that, I continued with the power connector and the electrolytic capacitors, ports, jack, and the LED. Finally, the panel was secured using the nuts for the Tonky Con jacks. So, after the usual checks of the power rails and the power consumption, let's check how well the hold capacitor keeps up the charge by making a droop test. I'm connecting 5 volts to the input and the LFO will trigger the hold circuit every 30 seconds. The output is connected to an oscillator with a chromatic tuner. The drop from a perfect A to a less than minus 10 cents in 30 seconds is acceptable, I think. Next we have a classic use of the sample and hold, where I use the noise source to produce a random control voltage. And finally, a sort of bit crushing demo where I trigger the sample and hold at audio rate to chop up the signal. But that's all that I got for today. Thank you for watching, and I see you in the next episode. Bye for now.